On the last episode, we built this 19,999 simoleon lot so that when we move our sim Evie Edwards in, they would only start with one simoleon. And the challenge is to get from one simoleon to 10,000 in only 10 sim days. Now, yes, as you can see, I do have mods installed, but none that will affect the outcome of the challenge. And there's also one more important thing that I'm forgetting, which is we did a part zero where we created the sim and randomly assigned traits. And what I was going to say is, yes, I've got seasons, and this neighborhood is in the middle of autumn. So that's the only kind of thing you need to know before we start. So let's jump on in. I also have get to work, which I think is going to be very important in achieving the full potential of this task, because I am bargaining on Evie getting a job on one of the playable career lots, and that way we can focus on our skills and harvest things. I don't remember seeing this. A scientist who proves they've got the grey matter to change the world as we know it can unlock new outfits like the UFO Hunter or objects like the Swanky Chemistry Lab for concocting new inventions and serums. Okay. So we will go to work Tuesday and Friday, but then we'll have Saturday and Sunday off. So that seems good. Okay, time to start making the money. Although we have to also actually complete some whim and get some satisfaction, because we were dealt the horrible blow of being assigned the location aspiration of City Native. And as I said last episode, this trait benefits only those Sims who live in San Myshuno. So I feel like, I mean, Evie is already hungry, so I'm just going to travel to San Myshuno. Although it's 2 a.m, so I don't know if any of the food stalls are going to be open. Oh, we can't even get past this aspiration because we have to give an apartment key to a friend, and you can't give an apartment key to a friend if you don't live in an apartment. Okay, so this is a lost cause, but I'll introduce myself to someone new in the three different city neighborhoods, and I will try ordering food 3 times, unless there is some food down here already. I might just sneak this. Oh, I don't know why I'm sneaking leftovers, but there's a... Okay, this is actually... Oh, we can go around, collect harvestables, sell some harvestables. Evie, where are you? Gosh, she's taking forever. Ah, yeah, okay. Oh, these are excellent quality as well, that's great. Ooh, they're gonna spoil any second. I hope the one she's eating isn't gonna spoil. No, it's fine. But watch, these are gonna spoil any second. Ah! And then they go. But we can, I know, it's disgusting. Go harvest. Snapdragons. Harvest some apples. Look for frogs. Now, actually, I mean, this is my own concoction. And I honestly, I hate this so much that I don't, the Sims 4, in my opinion, is not designed for a Sim to stay in one aspiration constantly. I think it's a hindrance, not just in challenges, but for everything in general. You have to be changing your aspiration all the time. And you're allowed to. The game lets you. You're assigned an aspiration from birth, which gives you a trait. In our instance, we've got the home turf trait, which we are getting a buffer from. A moodlet. And that's all that the aspiration gives you. You can change it and keep that trait. So, I'm going to change it. The best one to start out with is collect 10 collectibles. And, yeah. That's the best one to start out with. I think the needing to keep an aspiration the same throughout the entire duration of a Sim's life is unnecessary, and it defeats the purpose of being a Sim. Ooh, a leaf pile. Did I? This actually takes forever to walk. Crazy, or is she walking really slow? Now, once upon a time, you could harvest wild things to your heart's content and sell them for a profit, but throughout updates to the game, they have got rid of the ability to make a profit from wild fruit and flowers and things like that. I know what you're thinking, we're gonna go to work tired, but I am gonna work on getting some, in a moment we'll get some satisfaction points and we'll be able to buy a sleep replacement and everything will be fine. I don't intend on sleeping very much, because when a sim is asleep they cannot make money. There we go. Okay, now you've got these new aspirations, don't want to talk to you. I know. You've got these new aspirations to collect 5 crystals, collect 3 frogs, collect 3 fossils. Now, in regards to the frog, you can breed 2 frogs. And if you just drag them back in your inventory, it counts as collecting them. Now, I feel like I'm explaining how... Ooh. Okay, so we've dug up a scroll in which we can dig for treasure, but the scrolls themselves cost 80 simoleons, and sometimes treasure is not very bountiful. I think it's always better to sell the time capsules without opening them, because sometimes they can reduce in price dramatically. At 70 simoleons is great. So I'm going to sell all 3 of those, and we've made our first profit. But what I am going to do is I'm going to dig for treasure, No, I'm not going to dig for treasure. It's just better to sell the treasure maps for 80 simoleons. Because I think the only treasure you can get is like a rare My Sims trophy, which gets you a profit of 150 simoleons. And if you sell the chest and the map together, that is 150 simoleons. But it's sort of like rolling a roulette. You might not dig up a My Sims trophy. You might dig up something of lesser value. Can I get the sleep replacement yet, please? More treasure maps. Okay. Right. We need to sell our frogs. I honestly... No, at this point in the game, we need all the money we can get. Now, as for selling the fresh fruit, what I might do, actually, is I will sell all but one. No, maybe not. I don't know. I feel like living next to this grill, we're not gonna go hungry. I was worried about going hungry because a good way of never going hungry is to keep some fresh fruit in your inventory and just eat on it, and it actually gives you a positive moodlet. So screw that, what I just said. Let us sell it all, because we are very nearly at making our first 1,000. Now we just have to complete some aspirations. What is a good... I mean, actually, we could have planted something 3 times, but never mind, we'll... we can try that later, but I think for now, introduce self to 10 Sims and be funny to 5 Sims. That is what we need to focus on. And the sooner we can do that, the sooner we can get, sleep replacement. We're just 75 short. I can, she can take a nap. And that will give her 25, okay. I don't know if she'll want to nap. By needing the toilet. But, wait, what, we start in 2 days? Why does it say it starts in 2 days? No, in 2 days we have days off, right? What is going on? Is this a glitch? Oh, here we go. Work in 24 hours. Why can I not go to work? I thought today would be my first day. I guess we're starting on Friday. I guess if you get the job on the day that you start, you don't actually start that day, even if you get it before, like we applied for the job at 1 a.m. And I thought we'd go the same day, but no, they give you the first day off, which is actually terrible. I'm gonna let her nap through until this is completed, because completing this will give us a positive moodlet. See, we got a positive moodlet from our lazy nap. We desperately need the toilet, so... Oh, okay, we're way too uncomfortable. Okay, so we're gonna have to go travelling. Find somewhere that has a toilet. I mean, we could go to one of our places here. But, like I said... no, honestly, like, just... Forget this location aspiration, it's the worst. let's, like I say, focus on this one for the time being. And let's visit the nightclub and use their bathroom. Now, we can focus on some of these traits, get creative, dance to stereo music. I think we can do that down here. We click on the speaker, we can dance. See, so it's really good to have these positive moodlets because they outweigh us feeling tired, although we're going to become exhausted. Hopefully we can dance. Is it not going to... Sometimes it doesn't count this speaker as a stereo. I'm not gonna let her nap again because we've still got our positive moodlet. Hunger and fun. Tell a joke. Well, let's introduce ourselves to this sim. Why are they singing like that? Let's tell a joke. And hopefully we can get some aspiration points and get that sleep replacement. Oh, actually, before we tell that joke, switch the aspiration to joke star. And it will completely be funny to 5 cents. Oh, it did. It counted. What happened here? I think it was a ghost who drowns. They leave puddles behind wherever they go. Have I introduced myself to you? Okay, so when we want to introduce ourselves, we switch back the aspiration. And honestly, this is what everybody should be doing their entire game. Oh, we can send a happy text. Send a happy text. Okay, we're still good for this time being. Where did my sim go? Oh, there it is. Here we go. Well, Okay, you need to send that text now. We need the sleep replacement. Boom! Okay, so on the next episode, we will purchase our sleep replacement and we will be good to go. Hopefully, we'll pass the first $1,000 threshold and we will start our first day at work. And we will have completed day one in the next episode. So, see you then.